Hey YouTube, what is up everybody? Today we're going to be doing a Sai workout video. I hadn't done, I've been practicing on these. I'm not really used to smaller weapons, other than like maybe the nunchucks, or that's the only smaller weapon I'm used to, but like gripping, smaller weapons like these, because these weapons are meant for close quarters, not really long range tactics. I'm not an expert with these. I've been teaching myself off of the DVD, but I've learned a lot on my DVD. How I've learned to hold them. Basically, these are size. I call these the giant forks. Well, that's what most people call them anyway. Giant forks. These were used in China a long time ago. It wasn't really a Japanese weapon. It was more of like a Chinese weapon. But the Japanese incorporated some of the stuff from the Chinese. So these were basically farm tools, you know, for gardening. You know, that's how they dig their holes in the ground to plant their seeds, you know, to grow their plants, to grow their vegetables and stuff like that. This is how they managed to survive if they would get attacked by bandits, because they didn't have no weapons to really protect themselves at the time. That's just a little Sai history that I do know of. I don't know really the full Japanese name of the Sai, but or the Chinese name. I'll probably have to look it up later and put it in the video. I don't know. But I know they're a type of form of Budo weaponry training. Yeah, just, you know, if you don't know me, I'm 7'4". Hit the like, hit the subscribe, hit my out, leave a comment below what you think of this video. I'm not going to do no instructional video of the Sai, because like I said, I'm not an expert. I'm just, you know, still a beginner at it, but, you know, I'm just kind of messing around as I go along with what I do with these. So, these are still new to me. Bear with me. It's like I said. I am no expert with these. So if you think I'm an expert, that's fine. That's your opinion. But I am no master with these. I am saying this again. I just train on these. I just recently started with these. I'm just showing. Thank you. up and let the hand open. Now this is going to be changing grip and then strike. Seven. for you. My right, my left still needs practice. Do those, follow along with the video if you can. Let me know in the comment. You know, if you don't have a set, you can order these on Amazon. I don't know how much they'll be. I got these for saw these at a tournament. $50 for a set of real practice ones. Like I said, I'm not no expert in these, not so ever, but I do give it a try. But yeah, they are good weapons. They are good to train with, you know, for weights, you know, to work on your punching skills and once in a while. If you want to do if you want to work on your long finger strikes, or the eyeballs or whatever, you know, the finger jab, you know, you can do that, you know, try to shoot that out like that, you know, it helps you. to keep that finger straight going in toward the eye. That's the only plus I like about working with the sides on that part. But like I said, this Japanese size or something new that I just picked up while that. I just hadn't really made a video on it. But yeah, it does give you a workout, gives you a good burn in your arms and everything else. But like I said, just, you know, you don't know what you're doing, watch videos on it. There are all kinds of videos on how to use the size, you know, as, you know, for a form of practice in the martial arts. That's what I did over the years, and I finally decided, well, none of these videos ain't really showing me anything. And so I went online, I looked around, I had it, and I saw this karate guy, big heavy suit, karate guy, I don't know, some Japanese dude. I'll get the name of the video, I'll post it in another video on what I learned on the size, not really all the word. I'm not going to share the link down below where to get it at, but like, yeah, it's just hit the like, hit the subscribe, hit the bell notification. If you like this video, if you want to see more of the size, let me know down in the comment down below. It's just normally I practice the sword, I practice the bow staff, and the nunchucks mostly all the time. If I get bored with those, then I go back to these. I mostly practice on technique drills, or I'll do calisthenics or whatever, but it's just, I like to mix my training up. You know, there you have it. You know, please hit the like, hit the subscribe, leave a comment down below, hit all on the bell notification. You'll get every one of my videos. If you don't know me, I am Seth McDonald IV. Please hit the like, hit subscribe, and I'll see you.